Hello everyone, welcome back to PJ's CAD class. Today I'm going to answer one of my subscribers' questions about this Cuban style chain. Are you ready? Let's get started. Before we get started, let's take a look on the resource that we can find online. Before I start making any model, I always like to take a look on how they actually construct it. So if you go on Google and type Cuban style chain, you kind of see this all different kind of length and the size, but they all share with something in common. You can see the link itself, it's like a wire. Usually it is round or roundish shape. And it's a profile. Then you sweep them, they become one link, and then you kind of twist it in certain angle, then you cut the bottom and the top off, and then after high polish that catch a light. So it's really popular chain here. With that in mind, and we can understand the structure, and let's start making the model. Here's the model, and I'm going to go back with the step that I make, so you can kind of follow my thinking process. So I'm going to delete all of this, and let's take a look just on one link. As you can see, the link, it's been twisted, and it's been cutting top and the bottom. And also, there's some cut here, and that's because I don't want the other link coming and blocking it if I have another link there, so that way they are not touching and it's flexible. So let's take a look how I started. So I'm going to delete all of them, and basically I have two shapes here. The first, it's going to be my rail. The second one, it's going to be my profile. And then you can have any of the shape that you want. You can have a completely round or completely oval. I just like this cushion looking things, and they are living under the square tool, and one of it on the very bottom one, it has a conic corners. So if you use that with the conic corner, you can have this kind of cushionish looking. Okay, so once we have the curve, next things we wanted to do is go to surface, and then you can sweep one rail. You select the rail, you select the cross section, and then you hit enter. Then you will have this shape here. Okay, so one thing before you making your chain, you need to make sure that if your chain link together, they will fit. So let's take a look, let me put it into the ghost view. Let's take a look on this one. Imagine that I have one chain is coming here and another chain is coming here. You need to make sure that they were fitting in this empty space. If your link is too fat and it won't fit both of them, and then you're gonna have a problem later on. Okay, so that's first things we want to make sure. Then what we wanted to do is we need to twist this guy. Okay, I'm going to use the twist command. It's living under the transform, and you have this twist. Or you can go to the drop down menu, and then you will see the twist right here. Or you can simply on the command bar just type it twist. Alright, so I'm gonna use the twist command, and I'm selecting this object to twist, snapping into the endpoint, and then holding my shift key and go really close to the edge. All right, now be careful, it depends on what the next point you click. Make sure you click on the right view, holding the shift, click on it. This time I want to rotate it, I wanted to twist for 90 degrees, and then so I will type in 90. So you can kind of see this link is twisted, all right? And because it's hard for me to see, I need to make sure they are flat when they sit on the table. So I'm going to rotate it back 45 degrees. Oops, in this case it's minus 45. So now they are back into the flat position. Okay, so I have one link over there. Next things I wanted to do is to double make sure that the space that I have is still working. So I'm going to move this guy right here and just want to make sure that they are working nicely. All right, the one I showed you earlier, I need to cut down the space in between, or bowling different space in between, that was doing 60 degree instead of 90 degree. In this case, since I have 90 degree and they are not touching each other, so I don't have to do the bowling difference. Okay, so I'm going to put this back, and then the next one I wanted to do is just making a cutter. In this cutter, I want this cutter go up a little bit, and depends on how big of an area you want it to cut. All right, so let's do a test. I'm going to have that one, and let's go to the front view, have that block mirror, type it zero as my center, and mirror to the other side. Okay, and let's do bowling difference, this guy out of this guy and this guy. All right, so let's take a look on that, and let's try it one more time. Let's move it here, take a look. All right, so if this is too high to you, you might want to do 60 degree instead of 90 degree. Okay, but let's take a look on this. You can do is using the array tool, and let's go to transform. You have array with linear array. Okay, so I wanted to do is, let's say I want to do file link, and then starting with the center and moving this guy, holding my shift key, so they will be equal. Okay, and then I can move it here and just want to take a look if they are too high. So I'm going to do a comparison by putting this guy to here. Oh, I should just move it. All right, so next I'm going to do a comparison for 60 degree. We're gonna do exactly the same thing. Sweep one, U is the rail, this is the cross section, and then we know the size is going to fit, so I don't have to double check. I'm going to do is twist. It's going to twist from the end to the end, going to the right view, and type it 60. Okay, and then since it's a 60, I'm going to move it back minus 30, so you will come back like this. Okay, and I'm going to making a cutter and move it up a little bit, almost similar like the one we have in the position with the earlier one, and then I'm going to mirror to the other side. All right, let's take a look on that, and let's do the bowling difference. All right, so this one is a little bit lower, but you're going to facing one thing is when you have this one here, if you look at it, it's kind of cutting each other. I'm going to turn this one in the red color so you know what I'm saying. Let's move it to the red. So you kind of notice the black one and the red one is cutting to each other. So what we wanted to do is to move this link to the other side and make a copy on that. And we're gonna use the red one as our cutting object. So bowling difference, this guy will be bowling out from those two. So now we have a cut over there. If we do a test, moving this back here, and then you're going to see it's not touching. All right, so that's how you cutting this notch out. All right, so we are going to do the same thing. We're going to the top, and use the array tool. It's under the transform array linear array. Okay, we're gonna do the same 5, and let's move it, eyeball it as close to where we cut that surface. All right, let's take a look on the render view. In the perspective, let's take a look on the render view. All right, so this is your Cuban style chain. I hope you enjoy the video. Let me know if you have any questions or any other Rhino video that you would like to see. I will do my best to make a video for you. Thank you for watching. I'll see you next Monday.